Klondike kingpin, Tony Beets, is fighting to save his season. After a chaotic start, he's looking to make up for lost time.
So right now we have the trommel going on Paradise Hill. We have the new plant going here on the Indian. So that there's two. Now we'll be sure nice to get something else up and running.
With two operations running, Tony's ready to break out his secret weapon.
After all we had this year, now we'll be sure nice to get a dredge going. Hopefully we're gonna get some gold in the box to help us with our total a little bit.
Hey guys, where are you guys at?
Over here.
To get the dredge up and running.
It's kinda nice to be back on it, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, it is.
Tony's called in Greg Mason, one of the best dredge masters in North America.
Let's see if we can get it on the go, that's all I gotta say.
Helping out, trusted Lieutenant Len Hoekstra and electrician James McCrell.
How's it look, guy?
Hopefully, we can get this up and running.
The first hurdle, starting up the dredge's generator that sat idle for 5 seasons.
Let's fire this thing up. Is there any life in it?
All right, let's see what happens.
Got the power.
Are you all right, James?
Oh, yeah.
Just gonna check a couple things before we go boom again. Interesting. That's a big jump. Well, that's gonna be hard on a regulator every time.
We're kind of done.
Yeah.
The generator has short-circuited, causing the regulator to blow.
The sparks were going in between whatever, whatever. All that electrical stuff is above my pay grade kind of thing, but it's pretty much. So now what we're gonna have to do is, I have a second gen set, a bigger one, that was supposed to go on dredge number 2. Now we gotta hook it up and then see if we're gonna make that work.
Start it up.
Get the honor.
Oh, yeah. 480 and 60 hertz, so pretty good. Let's see what happens on the dredge. So if you push this one.
Okay.
That's good.
Yeah.
There it goes.
Generator seems to be working fine.
After 5 years in the dredge run would be awesome. Let's see what we can still make out of this season.
We can start up the stacker, the trommel, and the bucket line. Let's see what happens.
Trommel coming on.
We have no control
from up here right now.
Maybe it's something stupid we forgot about, that we have to do one switch somewhere, and then it will run. Play in off position for 5 seconds to reset the starter.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens. That's all we can do. Try it again.
Trommel coming on.
There we go.
Looking okay so far. Stacker coming on.
All right, stacker's running.
Yeah, looks good.
Okay, here comes the bucket line.
Yay! You got her!
There you go, dredge master.
We did it?
We did it. At least we got her running today, so that's good. This is more or less test without a load. So the big test is when we start dredging, then we got pay dirt and in the buckets. That's the big test.
If the dredge can start sluicing for the first time in 5 years, Tony will be back in with a shot of hitting his new 2,500-ounce goal.
I'm actually impressed how nice it is going. Shit, everything is working. It's awesome. Bring it around the corner and then position it in there in front where he's going to start dredging. I like nothing better than to see it run, guys.
It will.
Gentlemen.
All right.
Make it float. It'd be awesome.
Yeah.
The dredge needs to be moved into its first dredging position and attached to anchor points.
We're going to use two doses for anchor. We got a 700 excavator for anchor, and we're going to use the loader for the other anchor.
The dredge will be connected with steel cables to four heavy machines on the banks of the dredge pond. Winches on the deck then pull the 350-ton dredge into position and swing it in an arc from left to right, allowing the bucket line at the front to dig out gold-rich pay dirt.
There you go. Now the winch cable of the dredge is connected to the dozer.
It'll be interesting to see if with the winches they can pull it off. They got every corner cable hooked up, so if they do it right, she should pull right out of there. Look how nice the thing flows out of there perfectly.
I think if I go forwards, we got it.
That looks good.
Yeah, good. She's clear and you're floating. So pull, there you go. The whole thing is floating. Boy, that was sure nice to get up that gangplank.
Yes, sir.
Right? That's been a long time coming, you know that?
Yep.
Good, so you guys want to fire it up and make the thing work?
Should we need a bottle of champagne?
And well, you know, the way this summer has been going, I don't know if the old lady's going to go for that.
Yeah.
We may have to cut the champagne out, fill that bottle with orange juice or something. Anyway, if you guys want to fire this thing up, let it rip.
So I'm going to start up the trommel.
There we go. Perfect.
Stacker coming on.
All right. Stacker's running.
There we go. We got some water coming. Okay, here comes the bucket line.
After 5 years, Tony's dredge is finally catching much-needed gold once again.
There's your first dirt in the bucket. We got it going. That's good. Perfect. That looks pretty awesome, if you ask me. It's been a long time coming. It's nice to see it run again. Beautiful system.
At Paradise Hill, the Beets are meeting for their first gold way, running three wash plants, including the historic dredge.
Okay, weigh that dredge up. How long did we run it for?
I think only 2 days now.
Weigh it. One of you guys counts.
Yeah, let's do it, yeah.
For 2 days running, Tony's hoping the dredge will deliver at least 20 ounces.
2 ounces, 5 ounces, 15. Final is 22.56 ounces.
Worth over $40,000.
That's what we said, 1 ounce an hour, so yeah. It's pretty close.
The cost of running it is cheap.
If you can run that thing every day, 24 hours a day, it's a nice producer.